Hi, I'm Eric Grundhauser, community editor at Atlas Obscura, and today I'm at Syndaver, home of the synthetic cadaver, where, oh... Operating out of an unassuming office park in Tampa, Florida, Syndaver is in the business of making bodies. Syndaver was founded in the early 2000s by non-medical doctor Christopher Sakalies, originally in an effort to find an alternative to the sad practice of using sedated cats in medical training. Finding the available anatomical tools, cold, mechanical, and nothing like the real thing, Sakalies developed a unique formula for fake tissue that's little more than a special mixture of water, salt, and other ingredients. The company now makes cats, dogs, humans, and more, all totally synthetic and uncannily authentic. Believe me, we went there, and it was visceral. For as sci-fi a concept as chemical flesh might be, the process of creating the company's cadavers is more Frankenstein than Westworld. Sure, there are 3D printers running off bones and prototypes in hard plastic, but almost every component of Syndaver's products are assembled by teams of artisans. Sculptors, tailors, painters, and other creative types working together to create cadavers that look like they were made by robots. The facility even smells like an art studio. The scent of alginate, clay, and other unidentifiable chemical materials hit you from the second you open the doors. Throughout Syndaver's facility, workers were hunched over tables, meticulously building biology from scratch. Teams of two were busy assembling molded muscle and tissue, sewing away like gruesome tailors. They stitch the parts together using waxed dental floss. Mint, never cinnamon. Down the hall, Syndaver's primary veterinary advisor was intubating a canine model to show how they could inflate the lungs. This high level of artisanal care is all in service of what they call the empathy effect, that innate emotional connection to other living creatures, which other training devices often forego in favor of a cold efficiency. And this handcrafted realism doesn't come cheap. Even the least expensive Syndaver human cadaver costs around $45,000, which might seem somewhat crazy for a training aid, but compared to real human cadavers, it's actually pretty inexpensive. Cadavers require ironclad approval documentation, dedicated infrastructure and facilities to store and handle them, and then of course there's the shelf life. Flesh cadavers aren't exactly reusable. In the long run, a Syndaver cadaver with its replaceable parts and nearly limitless shelf life has the potential to save schools millions of dollars in infrastructure costs alone. Each model can also be customized to various purposes and levels of complexity. They can be made to breathe or bleed as needed, and Syndaver's models are now finding uses outside of the world of medical training, including as military and ballistics testing dummies. When we look to the future of human simulacra, we tend to think that the next quantum leap towards lifelike synthetic biology will come from the world of robotics. But Syndaver's focus on recreating the sensual experience of interacting with a formerly living thing might just be a next step. They might not walk around, but they look like they could. And time will tell whether Syndaver's products will end up taking all of the jobs from hardworking flesh cadavers, but in the meantime, it sure is fascinating to watch them try. Hey, thanks for watching. Be sure to click to subscribe and see more videos from Atlas Obscura. And down in the comments, tell us what unusual factory you'd like to see us explore next.